as in ovulation. And here we have our primordial follicle. Now, the primordial follicle is made up of an ova, one egg, surrounded by a single layer of follicular cells. The primordial follicle contains an ova which has its chromosomes arrested in prophase 1 of meiosis 1. Okay, this primordial follicle then changes into a primary follicle, where it then develops a zona pellucida and multiple layers of follicular cells, which are then called granulosa cells. This primary follicle then changes into a secondary follicle, where the multiple layers of granulosa cells soon develop fluid-filled cavities right here. And it also develops a second layer of cells called theca cells. Now, the theca cells are divided into theca interna, which is a dark green one, and theca externa, which is a light green one. The secondary follicle changes into a graafian follicle, where all the fluid-filled cavities form one large cavity called an antrum. Okay. Also, the fluid filled in this egg pushes the ova to the side, and the layer of granulosa cells that covers the egg is called the corona radiata. Now, the egg is growing due to release of hormones from the pituitary gland. Normally or spontaneously, our hypothalamus secretes GnRH, gonadotropin releasing hormone, pulsatile. We don't know why it releases it, we just know it releases it every month. Gonadotropin releasing hormone from the hypothalamus, which is right here, causes the anterior pituitary to secrete FSH. And LH. Now, FSH is what causes this follicle to grow, and LH is what stimulates the theca cells. Okay, so if we were to draw this out, this is what it will look like. We have the granulosa cell, and then we have the theca interna cell. So what happens is that FSH receptor and LH receptor, which are all GS coupled receptors, so we have our LH receptor and our FSH receptor, right? So each molecule comes in. So LH will bind here. Remember, this green cell is the theca interna cell. LH will bind to the LH receptor and the theca interna cells, and this causes cholesterol to change into androstenedione by the enzyme desmolase. Androstenedione then changes into, well, androstenedione then goes into the granulosa cell, and with the help of the FSH receptor, androstenedione changes into estradiol by the enzyme aromatase. So we can see that LH stimulates desmolase and FSH stimulates aromatase. Okay? Right. So eventually, this egg, which was in the graafian follicle, bursts out of the graafian follicle. Okay? This egg, which is in the graafian follicle, comes out of the graafian follicle. It comes out of the graafian follicle. Okay. Now this egg, which is in the graafian follicle, is now in metaphase 2 or meiosis 2. Okay, so this egg comes out of the graafian follicle. It bursts out. And then it travels through the fallopian tubes. Now, this graafian follicle degenerates and it forms what is known as the corpus luteum. Okay, so I will show you a picture of the corpus luteum right now. Okay. So this is what the corpus luteum looks like. The corpus luteum is nothing but all the luteal cells, which enlarges and they start secreting other hormones. Okay. Now this estradiol, which was produced by the granulosa cells, will undergo feedback inhibition and inhibit FSH and LH, because we don't want any more than one cell to undergo ovulation. Okay, so this has been ovulation, and I hope that was helpful.